This video was brought to you by the ILC. Hi there once again. Welcome to episode 15. In this episode, we're going to learn how to sketch a piecewise function, which is actually two functions in one. Let's give this a try. So, this looks like kind of a big mess here, but if you look here, it looks like we've got two functions, one here and one here. The first function, which I'll call piece A, is negative 2x minus 2. And the second one, which I'll call piece B, is x minus 3, the quantity squared, minus 5. Notice that after each function, we have a condition that goes with it. We have x less than 1 for piece A, and x greater than or equal to 1 for piece B. First thing we should probably do is go onto our graph and label that changeover point, x equals 1. Go ahead and draw a dotted line here. That's x equals 1. Now, if we are less than x equals 1, that puts us in section A, which I will label here. But if we are greater than x equals 1, that puts us in section B, which I label here. So, in piece A, the first function is true. And in piece B, the second function is true, and at x equals 1, we'll have a changeover between the functions. The first thing we should do for our first step is to find the value of each piece at x equals 1, because that's the critical point where piece A changes to piece B. Let's start by finding the value for piece A. At x equals 1, well, our function says negative 2 times x minus 2. So if x is 1, it'll look like this. Negative 2 times 1 minus 2, which gives us negative 4. If you watched some of the previous episodes, you'll see that we have x less than 1, and as I've mentioned before, if you don't have equal to in the condition, that means that's an open circle. So we'll go along the dotted line, find negative 4, place an open circle there. Then we're going to repeat the process for B. So again, we're going to say x is equal to 1. Our function becomes 1 minus 3 squared minus 5. Well, 1 minus 3 is negative 2. Squared makes 4. Minus 5 gives us negative 1. Now notice our condition contains greater than or equal to, which means it is a closed dot. So we'll go to negative 1 and make a closed dot. Now that we know what the changeover point looks like, our second step is to sketch each piece. But we're going to sketch them separately. So we're going to do piece A and then piece B. Let's go ahead and start with piece A. Well, piece A says we have negative 2x minus 2, which you may recognize is a linear equation. So it's just a line. Well, the easiest way to get another point on that line is to remember that the number that doesn't have an x next to it is the y-intercept. And that means another point on this line, seeing as how we have negative 2 here, will be 0, comma, negative 2. Let's go ahead and draw that in as well. Here's 0, and here's negative 2. So now we'll just draw a line that connects those two dots. Make sure that you stop before you cross the dotted line, though. Only sketch piece A within region A on the graph. Make sure you don't cross into B. So that's region A taken care of. Let's go on to region B. Now region B has x minus 3 squared minus 5. If you've watched the previous episode, you'll recognize that this is a parabola. And the first thing we do with the parabola is try to find the vertex. Well, remember the number on the outside is the y-coordinate of the vertex. That would be negative 5. And the number on the inside of the parentheses is the x-coordinate of the vertex, but it's going to be the opposite sign. So the vertex doesn't have negative 3, it has positive 3. So we're going to put that on the graph as well. We'll go over here to 3, and then down 5. We'll place a dot there, and we'll just sketch the parabola based on that. Again, make sure you don't cross over into A. Stop at the dotted line. Once again, doesn't have to be perfect. The point of this entire exercise is to be able to draw a graph quickly without having to plot every single point. All right, next time I'm going to show you how to write your own piecewise function based on a word problem. I'll see you there.